So in the main principal chain there are 5 carbon present, so we call it pentane. For 5 carbon we use pent, for 1 we use meth, for 2 we use 8, for 3 prop, for bute. The long list is there. So for 5 carbon we use pent. So in this particular example, 5 carbon are present in the principal chain, so we call it pent, and there is no any multiple bond present, that is double bond or triple bond, so we call it, it is a alkane, so we call it pentane. So firstly give the name to the principal chain. In this example the name is the pentane. So the fourth step is that we have to determine and name prefix, that what prefix we have to give this compound. Basically the prefix we give is the substituent. We have already discussed, prefix is the substituent. The substituent that is attached to the main principal chain is used as the prefix in the name of that compound. So in this compound our functional group is the hydroxyl and this carbonyl. So for the basic rule is that we can use only one functional group as the main functional group of the compound, and the rest of the functional group will be used as the substituent. Only one functional group can be behave as the main functional group or can be prioritized as a main functional group, and the rest will be considered as the substituent. So in this particular compound we have two functional group, that is carbonyl and hydroxyl. So if we see the priority order, then we can identify that the carbonyl functional group is prioritized more than the hydroxyl. So we have to give priority to the carbonyl group over the hydroxyl group. So our main functional group will be the carbonyl, and hydroxy will be behave as the our substituent. So in this particular compound the chain is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we have two substituent, that is this and this. So for this substituent we use methyl, and for this OH we use prefix as hydroxy, and the main chain we have already given the name pentane. So this is the fourth step for the nomenclature. Now we complete the numbering. After doing the adding of the prefix, we give the numbering to the compound. So from where we should start the numbering, always we have to start the numbering from the closest of the main functional group. That means we have to start the numbering from which our main functional group takes the lowest priority order. For example, in this particular compound the main functional group is the carbonyl, and so we have to start numbering so that it can be, get the lowest number. So if we give it 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, if we start numbering from here, so it will get the first number. So we have to start numbering from here. If we start number from here, this carbon, then the carbonyl function group will get the fifth position. That is not acceptable. So we have to give number from this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that it gets the lowest number. And both the methyl and the hydroxy are the substituents. Now the next step is that the assemble the partial name into a complete name using the alphabetic order. So now we have two substituent, that is OH and the methyl. Now it comes that which function, which group, which substituent will get the priority in the name. So we have to give the priority according to the alphabetic order. As we know that OH prefix is hydroxy, and the methyl, it is a methyl group as substituent. So let's see that the alphabetic order. We can see that in comparing the M and H, the alphabetic priority have to give to the H. So we will give priority to the hydroxy group over the methyl group. and we have already given the numbers for the main carbon chain. So now look at that. Where is the functional group present or the substituent is present? So let's do the counting 1, 2, 3, 4. So our hydroxyl group is present on the fourth number carbon. And if we see the methyl group position, it is present on the third number carbon. So here the name would be 4-hydroxy. We give the hydroxy group priority because of the alphabetic order. We give priority to the substituent according to their alphabetical order. So the name will be 4-hydroxy, 3-methyl, pent. As we have already given that the chain, main chain is the pentane. So it's the pentane, and now it's come the functional group. Here our functional group is the carbonyl, and for the carbonyl functional group we use L. L is used as the suffix. For carbonyl functional group we use L as not only carbonyl functional group, for the particular aldehyde suffix, particular aldehyde. Suppose if there is no aldehyde not present or any carbon chain, it is ketone. If ketone is present, then AL we use ON. But particularly in this example, there is presence of aldehyde functional group, so we use L as a suffix. So the name would be 4-hydroxy, 3-methyl, pent. Pentane is our main carbon chain, and AL is the suffix of our main functional group, that is AL. Aldehyde functional group is present. So here is the overall name of the chemical compound by applying all the rules of nomenclature, IUPAC nomenclature. Firstly, we have to take the prefix, which prefix we will use, that is other substituent or functional group present other than our main functional group. Then we use the roots, that is our main carbon chain present, parent structure, the main chain or cycle may be present. And lastly, the suffix. Suffix is the main principal functional group present in the chemical compound. So the overall example is given. We have to give the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the main chain, there are 5 carbon present. So we have to take pent. And there is no any multiple bond present. It is an alkane. So we can call it pentane. Then we will see that which functional group is prioritized. Then in between hydroxy and carbonyl, carbonyl functional group is prioritized over hydroxy group. So we use hydroxy as a prefix, and our main functional group would be carbonyl. The another substituent is our methyl group. Then if we compare the order of substituent, then alphabetical order should be used. So we use 4-hydroxy over methyl functional group. So the name will be 4-hydroxy, 3-methyl, pentane, AL is the suffix. So here is the overall example based on the rules applied as the IUPAC nomenclature. So thank you for this. Next lecture we will discuss about the isomerism.